Hey guys and gals, I'm here with kind of a new series that I want to do for videos. I've shown toys in the past that I had when I was younger, the reboot stuff especially, and the Batman the Animated Series, Batmobiles, that kind of stuff. I kind of want to do more of those. I got into toy collecting to get those toys that I had when I was younger all over again, and I figured, you know what, this could be kind of fun to kind of give you a glimpse at the toys that were out in the mid-90s, which, if YouTube statistics are correct, a lot of you weren't born in the 90s. So I thought, why not start this off with one of my recent acquisitions, and that is the Transforming Jupiter 2 from Lost in Space. This toy line really does have a special place in my heart. Lost in Space is a movie that I have loved ever since I was little. Not many seem to really do, but I adore this movie. It gets me. It gets me so happy. So this is the Deluxe Transforming Jupiter 2, a toy that I had when I was very, very little. I'm guessing 10 years old-ish. This came out in the ancient times of 1997, and I was excited to get it. It features the hyperdrive engine struts that pop out. That's why it's the Transforming Jupiter 2. It's got minifigures. It's got magnetic spiders. It's got battle damage. It's got missiles. At least the one that I had when I was younger. It had all those things. There were apparently two versions of the Transforming Jupiter 2. They both have all the same features except for one very important one. The one that I had came with a miniature Major West and a robot and about 4 to 5 spiders. This one, it has 6 spiders, but you may notice action figure fits inside cockpit, not included. Aww. That's right. This one is made to hold the 5-inch scaled figures of the line, which I've never seen this before. It is essentially the exact same toy. This one is scaled slightly bigger to accommodate a larger figure, and it has 2 more missiles than the previous one. Well, it has a secondary missile launcher. The previous one also had 4 missiles. It has the same lights, the same sounds, the same transforming gimmick. It's just slightly bigger. They did the same thing with the Bubble Fighters. There are some that have the minifigures, and there are some made to accommodate the 5-inch line. I find that very, very strange, and I don't recall another time where that's happened. I say that knowing there's a good 20 of you listing 1,500 bajillion other times it's happened, but in my experience, this was one of those few times. So if you are looking to buy this thing off eBay, if it does come in a box, if it has this red text, keep in mind, that is one that requires a larger figure. It doesn't come with the minifigures, and don't make the same mistake that I did. But you know what? All opened up, this thing, I have to say, it actually looks better than the one that I had. They are visually identical, except this one does have a higher bubble chamber for the cockpit, which really does look weird. If I had any skills in 3D printing, I would love to take this and really just shrink it down so not even a figure could fit inside. I don't care about that whole gimmick. It's nice it's included, but I just really want to have a Jupiter 2 on display. I would love just to shrink this down just to about that height and just make it a lot sleeker and look a lot better. But the one thing I'm noticing is this one features a lot better paint job than the one that I had. I seem to recall the smaller one having not really a cheap look, but kind of an overall glossy toy paint job. This one, you can see the gray has kind of a matte finish, while this blue has a nice gloss, and it really does stand out pretty well. It has a slightly weathered look a little bit. But overall, I absolutely love this ship design. I realize it's an egg. Why would I like it? But it gets me going. So this features a lot of things. It has lights, it has sounds, it has a lot of buttons you can press. We got a button. We got technically kind of a button, and a button, and a button, and a button, and a button. There's lots and lots of buttons. I like saying the word button. So to get things started, of course, you hit this little switch, the cockpit opens up, you can fit inside figures. This was made for the 5-inch Lost in Space figures. I don't have any of those on hand to really try out. I don't have any 5-inch figures now that I think about it. I know figure arts don't fit. I know 4-inch and 3 and 3/4 inch figures fit. My personal favorite is to take our little space explorer, pop him inside, and he's ready to go see the stars. So that's what I like. It's very, very basic, and you can put a figure inside. It's a feature I'm not a huge fan of, but it's included, so hey, that's nice. We do have, of course, some missiles that fire. You push this, we get a gun. Now, this was on the smaller one that I had. This is new though. This is on the larger one only. If you want to have missiles for these guys, you go on the underside. You got a little door, That opens up, and you have your missile storage. I don't know if I ever made that connection when I was younger. I'm hoping I did, but I don't know. Who knows? Younger me didn't know, apparently. Now, the weird thing about these is you would think that they would use the same missile for both of the launchers. You would assume that. You would, and you'd be wrong. Because if you look very closely, let me see if I can pick out which one is which. Okay, here we go. If you look, there is one missile that has a ridge, and then a ridge, and then the whole bottom is solid. Whereas this one, there's a ridge at the top, and then there's a ridge at the bottom. So you have missiles that look very, very similar until you hold them side by side. Now, of course, one missile works in one type of gun, and then one works in the other. If you do pick up this one, be very, very careful. It's basically trial and error to figure out which goes in which. If you do want to try them out, I recommend doing this one. Do this top gun. Don't stick anything blindly in these. They will get jammed and you'll have to pry them out. So for this, there's a little white dot on each of the missile, and there are little white dots on the gun and then the front section there. So try them out in this top one. If they fit, they will lock in place perfectly. But if they're the wrong type, you will see that they just don't fully fit in place. They're way too springy, and that will get stuck. So do that in the bottom one, put it in there, take that one, put it in there. I don't remember which one was which, so let's find this out. Let's put this in the top one there. That one fits. And then last but not least, we got this one. I'm gonna come back to the missiles in a bit. So for the next button, we have this one up here that has lights and sounds. And then, so the lights shine all through the sides. They shine through the top, through the back, and it really looks overall cool. Now, the one thing is, I honestly do not remember if the one that I had had lights. I'm assuming it did. I've been told it did. But I don't remember the lights at all from what I've seen. That just doesn't look right. It looks kind of dim. When I first got this thing, I put what I thought were brand new batteries in it. The sounds worked, but the lights didn't. I was unscrewing everything, and then suddenly the lights started working. So I don't know if the lights are messed up, if the batteries aren't as new as I thought they were, or if that's how bright it's supposed to be. The lights look very, very dim to me. So I don't know. Maybe they're supposed to be brighter. Wait, come on. There you go. Who knows? But you're onto the side here. We have this little button. When you push this, we get the transforming gimmick, and that is the hyperdrive struts popping out. This feature alone is just so enjoyable to me. Just taking this, if you want to close it, you just push back on this middle one, and everything else closes up. I could sit here for hours doing this and not get bored. That is just such a fun gimmick, and it works so perfectly. I kind of want to go through and detail this, just add some paint just to make it pop a little bit more. But I love this. I love this gimmick. You can see there's even molded in detail along all the little struts. So the whole idea is you take this. And then you got your hyperdrive engaged. Get it going. You're going into what I'm going to call hyperspace. We get. And then, of course, when you come out. If you want to see this with the lights off. It does shine through the edges pretty well. And it has an overall neat effect. And last but not least. Oh, and I didn't show off the top part. So that is a really, really cool feature that I'm glad is there. Close that up. Now we're going to fire the guns because we know the sounds are there. I love that sound. I don't know what it is. So if you want to fire the missiles, there are two little buttons, one on the bottom, one on the top. You push this one to fire those front two. So let's get it going. Lined up so I don't lose the missiles. And boo! Boo! Hey, one came right back to me. And these guys, of course. Boo! Right there. So there's that. Let me go track this down before I lose them. Because like all toy missiles, they really will get lost unless you take care of them. To the slightest degree. So I'm gonna go ahead and put these back under here. The fact that there's weapon storage really does make me happy. They didn't have to include this. They really didn't. But get that in there. Oh, you are crooked. I'm not going to match them up to their proper size and configuration, whatever. Just going to put them in there for the time being. Here's that. And then, of course, close it up, and you're good to go. This other panel, of course, is where your batteries go. This does require four AA batteries, so you just unscrew that, pop them in place, and you're good to go. Now, the last gimmick this has, I'm going to put that right there. You have your little switch here, and when you hit this, this little panel will shoot off as if it's having battle damage. Now, to me, I always thought those graphics looked like they were from Reboot. I don't really know why, but even to this day, I see this and I'm like, wow, that looks like from Reboot. Not the most detailed graphics they could have had, but the whole idea for this, get that back on there, is that you have six of these space spiders, everyone's friendly neighborhood space spiders. I'm gonna just, you can see what it looks like. It's not very, very detailed, but it's enough. Each of them have a magnet. The sad thing is, though, you have six spiders with six magnets, but they only fit onto that one panel, the one panel that shoots off. So that's a little disappointing. I was always kind of let down that there weren't more places where you could put the spiders. I do kind of want to take this whole thing apart and maybe insert magnets all through it so I could have the spiders hanging on in more than one position. But the whole idea is you take your spider, you stick it onto that one panel, and then, boop, there you go. It's gone. And they're found. So that's a gimmick that I always enjoy. I love battle damage stuff, and it makes sense to have a spider just, oh, where's the magnet? Stick them on the magnet, and then just, boop, launch them off into space again. There's the panel, and there's the spider. So it's a gimmick I really do like. This toy, it really holds up. I think that anybody could have this toy from the 90s to today, and they would still find a lot of playability in it. Now, one thing, though, is that if you wanted to display this thing on a shelf, it's kind of difficult to do, because if you just have it flat on a shelf, it does have these little kind of, you could call them landing struts, I guess, I don't know. Put on a shelf, and it looks fine, but there's nothing really exciting about it. Now, there are these two little holes in the bottom that I've only been able to think maybe they're for your fingers, so if you're flying this around, you have a place to kind of grip it, I don't know. But if you have a flight stand from flightpose.com, I've showed this off, I believe, in my Back to the Future DeLorean video. This thing is really, really handy, and it works perfectly. You just line up that with those two little holes. There's one. Am I in the other? There's the other. And, ooh, hello. Where is that hole? Where is it? There you go. There is a flight stand for your Jupiter 2. And I think that is really, really cool. I do want to get a shorter one of these. This may be the medium. I don't think it's the actual large. There's a small one that's like half the size of this. I think that would just look really, really cool on a shelf just to have your Jupiter 2 hanging out. I'm gonna go ahead and get the hyperdrive engines out and you are good to go. I'm hoping with a smaller one, perhaps I can have it angled more kind of like this. The problem with this one is that with the arms being so long, I don't trust them being able to support the weight of the ship, kind of going from extreme angles. But this is really, really handy, and it gives you a lot of display options for your Jupiter 2. So that's really all that I can say for this toy. I love it. I love having it again in my collection, in my possession. And I honestly don't know which one is overall better. If you want to see a comparison between this one and the smaller Jupiter 2, check out Toy Poloy's video. I'll have the link in the description. Or just search Transforming Jupiter 2. There's not many videos out there for it, and his is right there. He also has a comparison video for the two types of bubble fighters, so you can see the one with the minifigures and the one with the larger figures. I don't really know. If you are looking to get your own Jupiter 2, check on eBay. They're not going for that much. As I may have mentioned, because I've done this video four times now, I got this one for $15, including shipping. So that's really not bad at all. I think I've seen a smaller one go for about $30 buy it now. There are a bunch out there for buy it now for $200. Don't even bother with those. Those are just people who don't know what they're doing. But this thing apparently goes for about $15 to $40, give or take, depending on what version you want. This one, the larger one, I do think has a better overall paint job, and it is a larger toy. So those are two marks under the pros column. The smaller one does have that kind of glossy, cheapened toy kind of paint job. But of course, this one does have the really, really huge cockpit section I'm not a big fan of, and it really doesn't look quite as sleek. So that is a big, big complaint. But overall, I'm glad to have it in my collection. If I ever do pick up the smaller one, I will do a video on it and a proper size comparison. But for the time being, check out Toy Poloy's video. Oh, I forgot to also mention, when I was younger, I always wondered what this thing was. That actually flips down. That is the airlock hatch. So when they actually dock with the Proteus, that opens up. It opens up a different way, but it's a nice little detail they didn't have to include. But Trendmasters did it, and I'm happy. I'm so happy to have this with me again. So get your little spiders in there. So yeah, if you are buying this, make sure it is complete. Make sure it has all the spiders. If it's supposed to come with minifigures, make sure it has them. Make sure it has all the missiles. It should come with 4 missiles regardless. And I recommend this to any fan of the Lost in Space movie. I know a bunch of you are out there. Just it's a matter of finding you. Get up there. Yep. So that is it for this one, guys. I hope you have enjoyed this, and I hope you will like looking at these other toys from my childhood. Ones that I really do have a strong attachment for. And, yeah. Thank you for watching, as always, and I'll see you around. Take care.